In issuing this three-month report, published by the Uganda Law Society, it has expressed grave concern over the recent human rights violations, including the rampant kidnappings in the country. In responding to the kidnappings of civilians using drone vehicles, Colonel Moses Wandera said the army is not aware of drones that have been kidnapping Ugandans without number plates, as the army uses legal vehicles with number plates. He adds that they are ready to prosecute any soldier found guilty of human rights violations.
I also said, where there are instances of where some errant members of UPDF have violated human rights, gone outstepped their mandate as a force under the Constitution which is supposed to be defined, let us know. But you are not going to put the duty of finding out who is using drones PDF. You know who is to keep law and order. And I shouldn't be hearing this from a legal mind.
Deputy Police Spokesperson Commissioner Claire Nabaka said when law enforcement agencies ask them to join them in operations, they always respond. However, Nabaka also condemned the acts of torture and urged victims to report the matter to relevant authorities so that they can be investigated as soon as possible.
I don't have who asked the question. Do you have off-head someone who has reported that they were tortured? Because I think there are some agencies here who handle such cases. Maybe he could tell us something. Okay, that's where I was asking those cases. I don't have a case offhand, but what I can say, like I earlier said, about the Human Enforcement Act, Human Rights Enforcement Act, there is that issue of personal liability. We are on ground. We are educating. We are creating awareness towards the police officers against this vice. I think we have been attending some of even the workshops you have been creating. So we are really creating awareness. And the president said that anyone who does that will be personally liable.
Uganda Law Society President Bernard Owundo, in his speech, advised law enforcement agencies to ensure that they also follow the Constitution of Uganda, as well as the MPs who are still in jail. He urged the government to ensure that they are tried in accordance with the law.
We have raised some negative developments that are pertinent to rule of law in this country. The first is the increased arrests, kidnaps and torture. We've had in the recent past many instances of where people have arrested, citizens kidnapped and tortured. As Uganda Law Society, we condemn these arrests and we've continued to condemn them in different various fora. We have appealed to the government to ensure that when they arrest a citizen, let them do it in accordance with the law. What does the law say? There's a very big difference between an arrest and a kidnap. And our constitution protects the right to what we call personal liberty. Personal liberty. The constitution protects that right. And if you arrest a citizen, you have four fundamental obligations.
Story by Shamshad Naluja for the news.